All right, now I just wanted to roll over here and show you. Caitlin's holding a boa constrictor. Okay.
This is Princess Thor.
Princess Thor?
Yes.
That's kind of like strange.
She came with the name, wasn't my choice, but okay. It kind of fits her. She's a princess.
All right, very cool. So this is the nominate species of boa. Okay, so it's the Colombian red tail, I believe.
Yes.
There she is. They got the red tail. But I want to show you another boa species. You may not think this is a boa constrictor, but it is a member of the boa family, and this is Nebula. So we got Thor, we got Nebula. I prefer Nebula. I don't like Fat Thor. I don't know what they were doing in the end game.
I like Fat Thor.
Did you? I thought it was funny for like 10 minutes.
I mean, dad bods are in. So,
there you go. I don't know, dude. But this is Nebula, so check it out. What a beautiful anaconda. How long have you had this, Mike?
We've had her, I want to say, a year and a half, roughly.
Very cool.
We got her from a friend that was, you know, looking to place her.
Oh my gosh, man. Yeah. I actually am permitted to have anaconda where I live, but it's difficult to find female anacondas. That's a berm. Don't go sneaking a Burmese python in my boa constrictor or boa talk. So very cool, Mike. So this is the snake that, guys, just a few weeks ago, Andrew Biddle brought his 15-foot anaconda to us, and we did a swimming with. I love anacondas, you guys. This animal is a highly aquatic species. You can see, there's the eyes. They're placed,
How long can they stay underwater?
They can stay underwater easily an hour if they're not moving. Very similar to crocodilians in that way. They can, you know, with reptiles, the more they move, the more they're gonna need to breathe.
I don't know how many
you're
gonna take off.
That's okay, no, I'm not worried. But this animal certainly has a lot of growing to do. So that's really cool, man. So, you know, when she gets too big, you would just send her to me, Mike.
Yeah, we'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, keep that in mind.
Yeah, have two. We have the other one that Colin's using for shows today is her name's Gamora.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah,
Gamora and Nebula,
sisters.
You're a big Marvel fan, I take it.
Yes.
Yeah, awesome, dude.
A lot of our animals are named after Marvel or comic book stuff.
Ah.
This is Captain America.
And there you go, man. Well, I'm geeked out because I know Godzilla's on the way, and I can't wait to see that one. It looks amazing.
I'm excited.
Yeah, that's my end game.
In the Everglades?
There are no anacondas in the Everglades. They did put the snake, well, because... I know, but the thing is, the Burmese python is a very adaptable species. It can take cooler temperatures. So can the Indian python, which is more, it would be more of a concern, you know? That being said, anacondas, even though they're on the conditional species list, there have been no records of them breeding in the Everglades, and the reason is, Paul, it just gets too cold.
Yeah. Did they ban the green anacondas?
Well, they're banned in the way that you can't have them if you're just a hobbyist. Yeah. You have to have a business. You have to have a special permit. I do have that permit. My business is education, so it's good, you know, for me. I would like to get my hands on one of these snakes in the future and provide them with a cool home. So I always keep my ears and eyes open in case one needs to be placed. And in Florida, they have these amnesty days where if you own these animals illegally, you can surrender them to the authorities and they'll place them. So I always just wait. I'm on that list if somebody wanted one. Here, I'll tell you what, want to trade, Mike?
Sure.
I'd love to hold this animal. Just give it a hand.
Cool. The
cool thing about anacondas that you feel from the gut is the fact of how stout they are. They're a really, really powerful snake. This is the heaviest and largest by mass snake in the world when full grown. The reticulated python gets much longer, but it's a thinner snake, and as far as mass, it just doesn't have the bulk. So that's why when they say it's the largest snake, they're talking about the mass of it. Same thing with the saltwater crocodile. They say it's the largest reptile on earth because it's the heaviest. And as far as mass, but this is a, you know, this animal is giving me a workout.
Yeah.
So at this size, if this animal was not as acclimated to people and handled as often, if I were to find a snake like this in the wild and try to grab it, I would be in a lot of trouble. This snake is no joke. A snake this size could give you a real what for. So Nebula is definitely a formidable opponent in the wild. And I'm sure when she goes into feed mode, Mike, she's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
So there you go. And what are you feeding her right now?
Turkey legs, chicken legs. I want to say she will take guinea pigs here and there.
Cool.
And I know our other one's mostly predominantly just poultry.
Very cool. I got to say, man, Mike's a fun guy to have around. He's got some beautiful animals, so I really appreciate it helping us out with the video today. Same thing with Lucas. Thanks, Lucas and Caitlin. We learned a lot. We learned a lot about snakes today. I love it. Having fun here at Water Garden Weekend. Hope you guys are too. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you live in the Chicago area, check these guys out. Google them up. Crosstown Exotics, cold-blooded parties right there. You'll have a good time. And you'll learn something in the process of celebrating your birthday. All right, everybody, like and subscribe. Head on over to patreon.com/campcannon if you want to continue to support videos like these where we educate, not frighten people with these animals. Talk to you later. You got it. This is the only kind of snake felt I like.
Yeah, we use her in a lot of programs, actually.